thank you, God, that you have freed us from the yoke of this world. Lord, there is no one greater, no one more powerful, no one more wonderful or awesome than you. You are the Most High God, and in you there is complete and utter safety and refuge. In you we can withstand the trials of life, the evils of this world, and emerge stronger than before. In you, and you alone.
My refuge, and in my will take shelter.
verses 11 and 12. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. O Lord, your eyes are ever upon your beloved, those who are faithful to you. You would reach out your hand, you would send out your angels for us because we are yours. Cover us, Lord, with your protection. Send your angels to guard our steps as we tread the path of life in this fallen world. Because you are good.
Stumble, I will not fall.
tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. You lift us up, Lord. We rise up in our identity as a people of the Most High, and the enemy lies beneath our feet. We claim the authority to tread on the lion and the adder, to trample on the works of the enemy, and see your will be done. When we are in you, Lord, there is nothing of the enemy that we shall fear. Yes. Nothing. Up an army, God.
Yes, Lord.
that there is never any loss with you, God, but only gain. God, we thank you, God. We thank you, Lord Father, that in you, God, we have such peace and such assurance, God, and that there is no fear, God. verse 14. Because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. You see us, Lord. You speak to us, Lord. You say, I will deliver you. I will protect you. Lord, you make this promise to those who know your name. How good it is to know that you, the Most High God, is our deliverer and our protector. As we hold fast to you, Lord, we find peace in your embrace. Thank you.
Thank you.
with long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Faithful God, you speak these promises to us, but you do not stop there. You do not only talk of your love for us, but you showed it to us. On that cross, as Jesus hung, you showed us your salvation. The perfect and eternal demonstration of your love for all who would acknowledge you as King.
Jesus.
to know you is reward enough. To be known by you and receive your love and your grace is sufficient. But you pour out so much more than we deserve, God. Your protection, long life, honor, and a crown of glory in heaven. How can we truly fathom the depths of your mercy and grace? We love you, Lord. We want all to know of your great love. We want everyone to see and to receive your salvation. Yes, Lord, help us. Help us to be a blessing, God. We are blessed to be a blessing.
I look to you, I won't be overwhelmed.
morning we'll be lifting up North Korea, specifically the different communities that are involved with the liberation of the North Korean people. I believe that now is the time to push through the will of God. And so I invite you to come into agreement with me as I lead in prayer, and then follow with your own intercession. We're going to begin by praying for the international community, the United Nations. We see that God is moving within the UN, turning their attention to North Korea. So let's pray. Lord, I just thank you, God. I thank you that your heart is ever for the North Korean people, God. That you are shifting the minds and the hearts of the international community, God, towards your people, Lord. That you are bringing justice for the North Korean people, Lord Father. And we just pray, Lord Father, that your spirit would move within the UN, the Security Council, God. That they would be your agents of justice, God. Security Council. 조선조. The ethnic Koreans who live in China, God, near the North Korean border. We believe, God, that these are your people too, Lord Father, that your heart is for them, God, that you have a special purpose for them, a special plan for them, Lord Father. Lord, we just pray that you would bring revival amongst the ethnic Koreans living in China, God, and that they would rise up, God, they would see their mission, their purpose, God, to bring freedom, God,
yes, Lord,
to their brothers in North Korea, Lord Father.
Amen, amen, Lord.
Lord, use them.
Yes, Lord.
Use them powerfully, Lord Father.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
To share the love of the Father with their brothers in North Korea, those who do not know you, God. Your kingdom in North Korea, Lord Father. Use them, Lord. Lord, we pray. We pray for our Korean brothers in China.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes.
Help them to know their identity, God.
Yes, Lord.
To know their destiny, God. The North Korean refugees who are living here in South Korea. Lord, surely you have a mighty plan for them, God. It is no coincidence, God, that you have pulled them out of the miry clay, God. You have delivered them from North Korea, God. Because you love them, God. Because so you have a calling on their life. The deliverance of their people, God. Lord, just meet them, God. Meet them with power, with your spirit, God. Transform their lives, God. Let them understand the power of adoption, God, as they are brought in to your royal kingly family, Lord, that they are princes in your kingdom, God. And let them be established in that authority, that identity, God. That when you open the way, that they will lead a mighty army of warriors, God, back into North Korea to bring freedom spiritually, physically, for the North Korean people. Let's pray for the refugees who are living here in South Korea. Let's empower them. Let's pray for the Lord to meet them and counter them powerfully.
Burns for them, Lord. Your eyes fixed upon them.
plans, O Lord. Yes. Plans for your welfare and not for harm. To give you a future with hope. Yes. Lord, we lift up our brothers and sisters in prison, God, right now in North Korea, who are in chains. Physically, God, they are in chains, but we declare, Lord Father, that they're in their spirit, God, they are free.
Yes.
We declare, Lord Father, that physically they are prisoners of North Korea, but in the spirit they are prisoners of hope, God. Hope for the coming kingdom, God. Hope for life eternal. Lord, we lift up our brother, Kim Jong-uk, God. We pray, Lord Father, for his freedom, God. That it will be a prophetic symbol, God. A continuation of the freedom that you have released, God. A prophetic symbol of the liberation of the North Korean people, Lord. Over North Korea, God. Yes. Yes, God. Expose the works of the enemy, God. Expose the deception, God. release freedom, God, in North Korea right now. Freedom, God, for the North Korean people. We release hope into their spirits, God. We declare that they are prisoners of hope, slaves of righteousness, God. Though they may be in chains, God, in their spirits, God, that they are free, Lord Father. And we also declare, God, for those in North Korea who do not know you, God, that you would open their eyes, God, open their ears, God, release them, God, from that spiritual bondage, Lord, from the darkness, God, to see your light, to know your love, God. Yeah, we know, we thank you, God, that you are moving, God, in the nations. You're moving in the United Nations, God. You're moving in China, God. You are bringing people from all over the world who are just filled with a heart for this peninsula, God. We thank you, God, that you are mobilizing the nations, God, to bring justice and freedom to this land. So we just thank you, Lord. We pray this in Jesus' name. To just go into a time of free prayer. So I just invite everyone, with the exception of our keyboardist, to group up in twos or threes. And just for the next 20 minutes or so, 10 minutes or so, to just share some prayer topics and just pray over each other.
Lord, that your presence would go with us and that we would just spill